When a nuclear bomb devastates New York, causing it to be a small recreation of Mad Max meets Fist of the North Star, who do you call for help? The police? The military? Two really bad dudes? No. When the world gets crude, you have to get doubly crude. You have to get too crude. Or two crude dudes if you're playing the Genesis port. Or crude busters if you're playing the Japanese or European version. If I'm to be 100% honest, Crude Busters doesn't sound like someone that will kick ass. It sounds more like a 90s era household cleaner for the toughest of messes. Granted, too crude also sounds pretty awkward, to be perfectly honest. It probably would fit better if it was the other version of two, you know, T-O-O instead of T-W-O, which is probably the original intent, but hey, who can avoid a random pun? Or this is also the 90s, so you know, it was cool to be illiterate. Jeez, I wonder if I can blame growing up in the 90s for why I can't spell worth beans. Speaking of the 90s, this game is about as 90s as you can get. Even if I said that in the last game I reviewed. Hell, this even came out in the same year as Smash TV too, 1990. Kind of funny how games from the start of this decade seem to be able to define it so well. So yeah, you get to play as one of two chunky punk guys out to clean the mean streets of New York after previously mentioned a nuclear nightmare. Seems New York gotten taken over by someone named Big Valley, and he has turned the entire state into a frickin' Mad Max convention. Either that or a true-to-life scale version of Escape from New York. Wait a second, the big bad's name is Big Valley? What the hell kind of name is that? I'm sorry guys, but that might be one of the worst names for a video game big bad in history. Sounds more like a name for a salad dressing, Big Valley Ranch. So it seems your guy has to punch and kick his way through levels that have a sort of unique setup. At least it's unique for a beat-em-up. It's not doing the weird tilted belt scroller layout you typically get from games like Double Dragon or Final Fight. Instead, it's got this weird kind of two-story side-scrolling setup. And what I mean by two stories is that most of the level, there's a ground floor and a top floor, and you can jump up and down between them by hitting up and jump or down and jump. Kind of like if you took a game like Rolling Thunder or Shinobi and mixed it with Kung Fu Master or Splatterhouse. It's a rather weird setup. In fact, I can only think of one other beat-em-up that used a similar setup like this, and that would be the game Bad Dudes. A game that I'm sure we'll talk about with more depth in a future episode.
I'm bad!
But I guess I shouldn't be surprised by the similarities, seeing as both of these games are made by Data East, the masters of strange games. It almost makes me wonder if these games were meant to be spiritual successors to each other, or just unrelated games with a similar setup. But let's get more on track with Too Crude. Your controller setup is a joystick and three buttons. You have an attack button that lets you do punches or kicks depending on your position with the enemy and the direction you're pushing on the controller, or sometimes just whenever the game wants you to do one or the other. You have a jump button for jumping. You can also do an evasive roll by hitting diagonally down and jump.
See me rolling, they hating.
While the evasive roll can sometimes get you out of situations quick, it has no invincibility frames like more modern day games, so you will most often find yourself rolling right into an enemy and taking a hit. Go! The third and final button is the grab button. The grab button allows you to grab a variety of items from the background and either use them as weapons or throw them at your enemies, depending on what items you grab. There's just something awesome about being able to yank a street sign out of the ground and then proceed to beat the shit out of people with it. Time to sign out, bitches! This also includes grabbing actual enemies and throwing them at people, as well as even the bosses, which to be quite honest, is pretty badass. Now, what throws me off a little bit with the controls in this game is I can't think of any other beat-em-up that uses a grab button like this. Usually, the attack and grab buttons are usually the same, so this is a bit confusing at first. I find myself expecting to pick up things with said attack button and throwing them with said attack button, but neither of those work. You have to use the grab button to pick it up, and you have to use the grab button to throw it. Which I guess makes sense, it's just counterintuitive compared to what I've been trained to think for every other beat-em-up I've ever played. If you do hit the attack button while holding a heavy item, your guy will instead do this little goofy ballet kick at the enemies. Now, I'm not hating on this guy. Any guy who can hold up a car over his head and still throw a kick is pretty insane levels of swole, if you ask me. But that doesn't change the fact that the animation does look kind of silly. The game only has 6 levels, and they have you fighting in such levels as a cityscape in the snow, and a cityscape in a hurricane. Now, you might think that the reliance on cityscapes is lame, but if you do think that, let me remind you that one of the things I've said was a cityscape in a frickin' hurricane. It even has random giant billboards flying around that you can punch at the enemy. I guess your dudes are just so crude that even Mother Nature can't stop them. Also, the normal cityscape level is filled with lots of bright graffiti, really pushing the 90s rebellious punk feel of the game. This does cause what would normally be a pretty basic level design actually look quite spectacular. And the snow level even has an evil Santa Claus that throws syringes at people. Finally, Santa gave me what I truly needed, a COVID vaccination. In fact, this game has quite an interesting set of enemies, so let's take a quick look at them. We've got Zeta, Shit of the North Star, Flea Man, Flamer, Gas Mask Ninjas. Don't fuck with these guys, they can climb walls. And thin air, seemingly. Wait, what? The love child of Gene Simmons and Jake the Snake Roberts. Chuck McFunk. Scooby Dooby Don't. The Million Dollar Fapper. Santa Claus. Tanks for Nothing. The Ric Flair Brothers. Altered Beast.
Power Up.
Clarence Boddicker from RoboCop. Jim Carrey. European Cover Mega Man. The Killer Copter. Big Bad Beetleborg. That fuckface from Trojan. Zorak. The Termalamer. Charlotte. Dr. Wily. And Dr. Wily at the end of Mega Man 2. Yeah, this game definitely has a lot of neat designs and graphical flair, like this random sculpture of Satan on the wall in the laboratory. Like, why the fuck is this even there? There is nothing about Satanism in this entire game, but this is just here for some reason. What's it got to do with anything? I don't know, I guess they just got my goat with that one. The game also has a lot of voice clips to try and add personality, but they're not really funny and really kind of random and annoying. Especially when your character falls on his ass and says, "What a day." Because trust me, you're gonna hear that a lot, because Jesus and Crow, this game is really, really hard. And it's not a fair or fun challenge. This game is brutally unfair. And this is where the big problem with this game is. It's the gameplay. Your punches and kicks always feel too short to successfully hit any of the enemies very well. The game never seems to have enough things to throw at your enemies, despite that being a big part of the gameplay in this game, and the enemies take just way too many hits. And as cool as the enemy designs are, it starts repeating them way too fast. You don't even have to be halfway through the game before you start seeing the mid-bosses and actual bosses get repurposed as normal enemies, as if everything doesn't feel unbalanced as is. And despite only being 6 levels long, this game feels like it takes forever, because all these levels are really long for an arcade game and just makes everything feel 20 times more tedious and frustrating. The game even does one of my least favorite video game tropes in the last level, which is the boss rush, where you have to beat several of the previous bosses before fighting the final boss. I fucking hate this trope. But the absolute worst is the spider boss. He actually has a move that can kill you in one hit. In a console game, I can tolerate that bullshit. But in an arcade game where I actually have to put in quarters to play it, it actually feels like the game is outright stealing my money. Though, at least when I get the old one-hit death, I'm reduced to a pretty cool-looking skeleton. So with all said and done, the big question is Too Crude a good game? And the answer is absolutely not. I really want to like this game because I love the graphical design and the look of the game's background, and its presentation is actually pretty cool. I mean, I just love the whole Mad Max, Fist of the North Star, 90s punk aesthetic that this game is really pushing. It's just the gameplay ruins everything, and the gameplay is the most important part to any video game. There's no point in playing a video game if it's not fun to play. Range is too short, your character is too slow, and everything feels unfairly stacked against you. You often find yourself dying too much to have any fun, so yeah, this just isn't a good game. Like I said, it's got great presentation, but that's it. Everything else about it is just absolutely terrible. I give Too Crude a 2 out of 5 sodas. I guess this game is just too crude for me.